tunataka kwa wafugaji. Na venye nilikuwa natoka kwanza, community wangu tena ni wasichana wale shule. Na sarani hapa ni watu wana sana. Unahisi na watu wangu wote ya wello. And sometimes they don't want to understand for you to go to school. Because they want their kids to be superior. Wale watoto wamesikia hata kuna mtu anakaribia nini. Kwa hiyo tulikuwa tunahisi nyumba moja na mbuzi yetu na kondoo yetu watu wanasema I don't feel ashamed to say that. Tulikuwa tuna divide. Kiwani tunasomea hiyo nini? Moto. We use fire. Siku ya nini when there is moon outside. Saa vile tunaenda nje kusoma. Saa sile umemaliza kazi ya nyumbani. So you go out hivi. Sometimes I say thank God because I still have my hands. And that thing alone was making me strong. Say, how am I going to study? How am I going to be somebody so that I can help my mother? So that I can help my family? So that I can be like the other community? Even Sundays, I said, I took to Ghana, because I took one from Missouri. Lakini we appreciated what we have. Meaning I appreciate myself as Tegla. So I was saying, whatever I have is mine. So it is good that we have also other neighbors that they have almost the same background like us. But I used to go to them, my friends. Tunaenda kulala huko, tunashia hiyo nini watu ya. Wanakuja kwetu. Sasa that funding alone. Tukipeana ile encouragement. Ili tufanya tukakua watu. Na tukaanza kuongea hata na vijana yetu. Muta kini batia advice, mi sita sema huye ni opposite. Nilikuwa na stay ile advice yote muta na mbatia. Ukiwa ukisikia advice mbaya, unachichika. Don't say I don't want to talk. Kuna la kumbuka siku moja, kuna mtu mwingine, alikuwa na, he was a drunkard. Paso. But since my mother, ni, nyumba yetu ni kama, ni like this hall, my mother has a big heart. Ile hapo na tunakula yote. Watoto, kila mtu anakuja kwake. My brothers had to bring their friends. Vijana. Wote tulikuwa tunatreat kama mandugu zetu. Na wale nyumba ingine, wenye wako na kwa matachi, the rich people, they used to protect their hands, their daughters. We don't want them to mix with the others. Not knowing that sisi wenye tunatumbulika kila mtu, tunakuwa more, what you call, disciplined than when you feel like unakatasa mtoto, usisike hiki tu. Huyo mtoto atashika hiyo kitu aone what is going on. You see? Siku moja huyu msimu huyo au huyu wa family wa kuja. Huyu mtrama paso na katuita tu ile bro. I want to talk to you. Ule msana mwingine wa sana sema bro na kuku tu atrama paso. Wakatoka mimi mwenyewe nilienda nikasikiliza. Kitu ya kwanza niliambia unasikia? Wewe nikasema baba yako ako wapi? Na mimi ni sijui. Mama yako saa yako wapi? Mama yako ameenda kulima shamba. Mnakula nini mboga na chumvi? Baba yako saa hii anang'ang'ana kutafutia school. Nilipata mbali. Fikiria, ukichesa. You will be, utalaniwa. Hiyo ninaniambia, utalaniwa. But just take my advice. Don't look at me like a drunk person. But whatever I'm giving you, it will help you tomorrow. Remember your mother. She could be like the other women. But because you don't have resources, mama na kusirabolia, don't play around. Do not play around with boys. Yule mlega linyame hivyo. At the end of the day, enda mahali chuhoni, if you don't have anything, utarudi kwa mama yako. Usikule kiti ya mutu. Don't tell something which is not yours. Mutu asikudanganya na chips. Hata siku hiyo tatu kujua chips ni nini. Tuko na tunalima viazi kweli, lakini hatujajua maneno meaning ya chips. Nilijua siku ni nini high school. Nikienda town ndio nikajua ni chips ni nini. Hata mkate. Lakini hiyo advice yake yangu ilinisaidia. Hata nikienda high school. Hiyo ilinisaidia hata nikakuwa nje. So some of the friends they ran away. Later on wali regret. Say we wish we could have listened to that person. As I'm telling you, my sisters, kumbuka na privilege. Ambaye mtu mwingine ameenda kustruggle. Amjua njira aligusa nini. Aligusa maisha yake. Juzi nilisikia akiniambia the way she's struggling. I was close to cry. And now, with that ile uchungu, hakutaka kusema I don't want to help, but alichukua hiyo uchungu kusema let me help another person so that she can help another person. Do not take what is given you for granted. If I had taken for granted what my family gave me, I realized that I have to give it back. And when I went to high school, I was told not to do sports by my father because he did not want women to run. And he was thinking for me, because I was a good athlete, need to fail by exam. But I did not. We got the same marks from my with my brother. And for me, I had more advantage because I'm a girl. So I was given in a government school. Nakambia ndugu yangu, since you did not do well, you have to repeat taka nyumbani, sababu alikasirika. But my brother told me, you know what, go and talk to father. I said, eh? Sinji ndi kila sumu napendwa? Ah, hiyo ni shida yako. Baadaye nina realize, listen, I have to go and nibembeleze msasi. But he told me, okay, I will take my brother, but give me a word. Do not go and do sports, because I don't want to fail in my exams. Because now I have to pay. So nikaenda shule. With the word that I gave my father, I will not do sports. But not knowing that God gave me that talent. So nikaenda nikikunja. So Ricky Naso, nikaambia, so we know that you are good at it. I say, no, I'm not. Out of 400 students, almost 1,000, in Bahrain, where were good at it? No. Nikaenda. Where were the game here? Ambia, no, I'm not a runner. I'm not a good runner. Thinking that now when he came here, the only word, I came my word. My father will definitely say, no way, you will not go to school again. But the headmistress told me, you know, there are two things. Either did you read your school laws? I said, yes. Did you sign? Yes. What was the number 9, something like that, in the rules? What is all about? I say, oh, sports is included. But I've already signed. So these two things, either you go home or you do sports. I had to do sports. And for my pensament, I was given the other women who are completely overweight to run really with them. As a mono, now they're moving on a party, as a newcomer. They told me, you mono, so you are going to start 1 kilometer, you finish, you bring us the baton. Anyway, in the Kimbia. Good enough, my group of from fours plus from one myself, we won, but we were not good about it. I was the only one. That is how I gained the trust for the school, for the student in the school, and then again for the teachers. After 3 months going home, Kururi Nivani, of course I was in the radio that the national girls who was number 29 the previous years, we ran in E10. And normally in North Rift, we did not have good athletes. But running in E10, so we'll have other like Lelmoko, Kapenda girls, Singore girls, these are the best schools. But the school from West Kobo, really, winning the cross countries, it was all over the country. Seems as I'm scared. So come home, say, hey, hey, will you come here? Hey, come. So I say, I had nothing. So, Simbaba, you can give me a shule. And you, again, unge fries, I'm having a shule to Tulisinda. Like, because of good results, and because of this that I had, actually, it didn't say anything. So that's why I'm telling you, when you muko, ukienda nyumbani, hata kama nyumbani alikuwa anasema, no, you are not a good student. Ile utu utatoa kwa yule kwa shule yako, you will make a very good example to your community, even to your parents. And you will be able to make them to be proud. But when you leave this place, going to that community of yours, hata kama nyumba yenu inakaa kidogo hivi, and then you become proud that, I don't want to. Now there's this place very dirty. So you become complicated. So you are killing the trust. But when you go there, ujinyenyeke, uto ile uniform. Fa ile nguo, tunafanga mbani, be like them. Assimilate whatever you have down there with the need of teaching your mother or your community or your friend. People will respect you. Niko nikienda nyumbani na wale na wale viatu kwa nyumba na baa marinda yangu ya kawaida naenda kulima. And even today nikitoka Europe niende nyumbani, I have to go to the ground to to help other women, to help my family. I don't say I have these people who can work, no. Tukiwa na mfanyikazi nyumbani, I don't want to make myself to be special, but I do what other people do. Hata tukiwa na mtu mwenye mama, anasaidia mama, sisi wote plus hata kids, tukiwa nyumbani vile mtoto ama mama na kufumsika, sisi ndio tunafanya kazi. To make sure to be a role model of our people. And you share. So when I manage to live under my files, kusaidia wengine, so long as wasinini wasipasua. Sile vitabu, there are some kids that completely they don't have anything but just share. Because you know what, at the end of the day, God will bless you. And when God gives you a talent, even today, whatever you have, you can do sports. She can look for you at the opportunities to go and to study outside because of sports. In that, you have opened your hands, your eyes. You have opened opportunities for others. There are people who have talent to sing. Plus, this opportunity that you have given to have free education, someone sponsoring you, try to do something beside that. Be a good example for other women. As I talk like this, when you think of the women from Northeastern, the women from West Bogot or Turkana, there are kids who are more, maybe better than you people. There are cars that they travel 10 to 20 kilometers to look for water. Najua muda akiniambia sasa hapo na shida wa kibira jamani tu hata tusilalamike. At the end of the day unaweza pata ile nini leave from the cabbage. Hata maji. Kuna those cars that cannot access water. Wakienda mbali wanachukuliwa kwa njia. People will snipe them. Take them to be women. But for you, you are lucky. So, I'm really happy to talk with you people. You can be somebody. Before I think I was nobody, but today, the whole world respects me. Not because I'm a good athlete, or because I was a good athlete. It's the way you put yourself with the whole world. Mother could tell me, mate, if someone spied at you, don't return. If someone tells you are a stupid person, you really know that you are not a stupid person. Don't retaliate. Say thank you. And look at yourself. Did I do something wrong? Judge yourself. Did I do something wrong? Do not just use words to words. Go on your way. You know you are weak. There are people who are completely, they are professional of attacking people. They might see that you are a very bad guy. I can come and say, ah, you are not a good person. You are hard to say that. Or I can say, okay, you know what, I will tell her friend. I saw her somewhere. And then you become demoralized. You know yourself, you did not go to a wrong place. Just say thank you very much. Unless, come will go up on a buyer, and then you'll be able to react. But let's learn how to call diplomatic, how we can help our people. We can be a good leaders for this country tomorrow. We can be good women that change the world. For example, today we have women that married by high-ranked people, but they don't have utu, kamia wanjuru. They don't have the heart of people. These women, they could persuade their husbands to see that there are schools or also in those dry areas. They have opportunities, but they only see between themselves and their children. And they see the opportunity to steal from them. I do not want you people to do that. It will take only some few years for you people to be leaders. But even where you come from, you have a voice. You have a voice to talk. You have a voice to help. It's the way you take that courage. You take that courage, you will change a bad person to be a good person by playing diplomatic. By playing diplomatic, you'll never differ, even in your own class. Start from yourself. Start from your neighbor. I'm really happy when Wanjiru told me that some of you, or maybe everybody, you have a club in your schools. That is the wisdom just a little thing that you have. You started already. Just expand to another school also. Be a pioneer. Be examples for others. Kenya is our home. Kenya is our country. What? And why I'm saying Kenya is our home, Kenya is our country. This country is a beautiful country. I've traveled all over the world. But there is no place than home. There is no place than Kenya whereby I still have a neighbor, even though I don't know Wanjiru, but when I see Wanjiru, I say Wanjiru, today I don't have anything, please help me. But I can go to a house without even asking for appointment. So long as he's there, I can go and knock your door. Wanjiru, I'm here. She will not tell me, Tegla, you did not make appointment. There are places whereby you can make appointment even to your own sister, which is wrong as a human being. There are people, in fact, nowadays, to me, so I have to be a bad. SMS, whatever. There is not close relation. Maybe it's another culture that we need to renew our culture ourselves. If I have problem, I will be able to share with her and realizing that my problem so small, of which I was thinking my problem so big, and when I share with her, she will tell me her problems. But probably her problems are such a big like this that I say, oh. Mine is so little. So that's how people can live together. That's how we can educate our people. That's how we can educate even our mothers. My mother did not go to school. But today I'm proud because I know she protected me. She protected the leader. You are the degree that I have, or the name that I have, it belongs to my mother. It's the same to you. To say, my mother, or your mother. She did not eat anything, but she was able to feed you with the little that she had. Let's also go out and try to talk to our brothers. Because without our brothers bringing in same value that we have, you will work always parallel, and you have somebody pulling you as sharp like this. So my dear sisters, I'm really happy that I'm talking with you and sharing with you what I went through. When I finished high school, I thought that my days were finished. Coming from those areas in West school. And then I was thinking now, because I wanted to help women, I did not know how, because I always see women carrying firewood on their backs, carrying more than the children on their jeans. I say, I wish I had money to help. I wish I had opportunity to go from one village to talk to them that you have opportunities. When I wanted to be a nun, and of which I did my application, I was admitted in her house. I did not know the place. Unfortunately, I was not able to go there. Why? I did not have ID because I was underage. I did not have birth certificate because who was born in the hospital, and all those required my father and my mother. Going to my father, say, to do what he was thinking that I was going to have a job. And then my dummy brother said, oh no, he wants to be like a nun. My father didn't understand what's a nun. And then he said, he wants to be like a sister, like the Catholic. And I had already told my brother to do the same thing, and we got the admission. And my father said, no, we're not going. So I stayed. I know where to go. So I came to Cameroon. I was running 3,000. I won against Susan Selma, Esther Kiblagatos, the women from Nandia, very, very good. Against Margaret Kakiri from Nyeri, and Wangare from Nyeri. So, I met somebody from the Rift Valley City of Science Technology, and he told me you are from which over here. So, do you want to join our institute? I say yes, but I don't know how I can join that because nobody will pay my school. And then he told me, are you ready? I say yes. And then I was given admission. 1 month later, I went to Rift Valley City of Science Technology. I was the only people there. And I, by my own mouth, I had to talk about other girls at home because I had an opportunity. I say, no, I have 6 of our girls. They are very good. So, is it possible that you can admit them? I didn't fear, and that's why I'm telling you today. with the peer that you have, try to help others. This man did not say no. I say, okay, do you know their names? Do you know their contacts? I gave the contacts. So they six came, and we were given scholarships. But because these girls, maybe they did not go through the hard job that I had, or hardship, they did not want to continue with sports. And they say, we don't want to stay there, we want to go. And start to choose courses. Say, please, I asked for you, let's study, nobody will help us. They refuse, and they told me, let's go to get home. I say, no, I came alone. Now it's as weak as my stand. If you want to go, just go. But I did my best to bring you. But they left. I was left alone in Rift Valley of Santa Cruz. Or which I go to scholarship. Wakifunga shule nilikuwa nakaa kwa principal, nilikuwa nafakia nyuma ya principal na kukaa na watoto yake. So I was given a babysitter, but I was taken by that family. But I finished my education. That didn't make me that because I was just cleaning the school. I will not be somebody, no. Somebody has given me that opportunity. I had to make use of it. And even when I finished, I joined post office. Because I had no good father, nobody wanted to help me. It was only now through the triumph, my own struggle. You find someone who failed, is just being employed. At that, you have to pass on this. But mukiamini Mungu, Mungu atawasaidia. God will open your ways. And be a talkative person. Try to talk. Try to reveal yourself. But when somebody tells you, no, I give you, you give me this and I give you, say, no. If you don't want to help me, please, you know, understand what I'm telling you. See, if you don't want to help me, don't look at me because I have nobody. Just leave me alone. God will not leave me. And God will not leave you people. We have come a long way. So, going to Europe, I had to struggle. Why? I come from another community where they fight conflict all the time. Nobody wants to see somebody called Popot. My own federation, they told me you are not good enough. But I had to struggle. I did not use the newspaper to write bad things. No. I say, I better fight face by face. Writing doesn't help you. As a leader, even though you see what leader is your boss, don't go to the newspaper. You don't help her. Maybe she did something she didn't understand. Go to her and say, listen, I didn't like this. And I want this and this, and maybe if I'm wrong, please can you help me? I did not do that without the people to write on the newspaper. The same people that they were frustrating me, they are very close to me today. We work together. And we need to see that their life in this world is not an easy thing. But how? The way you tell it. Mvile mnachokuwa. Ndiyo itawasaidia. Ukichukua on the wrong side, itakuchukua on that level. Which were fit positive, always life is unbalanced. Tunasemanga ati ata nini, kila mtu hapa wana hiyo say, mkilala nyumbani nja, if you stay home, or if you sleep without food, you always put the vaccine on your face. You go out, people think that you ate something, but your face, you don't show your problem on your face. Hiyo ndio mama yetu alikuwa anatuambia, mkilala nja, wacha mkono yako na uniweke nini mafuta. Ukiharibu kwa sawa mwingine. Lakini tumbo, unajaribu kufunga. Si chakula peke yake, ni ile problem nasema. If you face challenges, you know how to deal with their challenges. There are people, they are happy to see you having more problems than solving, than helping. But you have to identify a good friend that you know can help you. So, as I talk that I'm also doing now like peace, I'm a peace ambassador, how? I realized that where I came from, a lot of conflict. And that's when I came with the idea that Tegla Loroupe should have a peace event in the district, for which we extended to Turkana and Karamoja and Marquette. And that was 2006 in Tana River, where the problem is. I had to go home. I could have stayed in Europe. I think many of you say, why she doesn't stay in Europe? No, that's not my home. That's kind of a place of work. You can go and study outside, but remember, your people at home needs you. That's not my home. And I told my friends, you know what? Together we can help my home. And when you visit my home, you have a place to stay in peace. Like I'm staying in my home. Those are our brothers. Like tomorrow we want to visit our sister in our home. And now she has to stay in our home in, when we have peace. Is it true? Mm-hmm. And if you don't have peace, do you think we can have people like that? No. And these are friends. We are all equal in this world. But how we put our continent look like. So, our brother told you that today that he's a reformer. Yeah, he was one of those people that they were just chasing animals because of resources. I want to tell you that we can tell ourselves, let's live together. But we have to understand, I tell Wanjiro, let's live together. Maybe I don't have a place of life. But Wanjiro, this is an example, that's not a time. I'm just going to give you an example. But Wanjiro comes and because he sees from a special background, she can come and an opinion. So we have to address these things to our leaders. Let us not squeeze at us and try to say, okay, we live together, it's impossible. Let us not cheat ourselves. Let us help one another so that the other people are being regarded as citizens of this country. For example, there are people that don't have schools. When a summer they study on under a tree and they are still in this country. How can you compare that kid with somebody who is in Nairobi? Who gets everything? The person alone doesn't go together with somebody who stays in Nairobi. And the same pass marks, the same exams everybody sits. And when it comes to both jobs opportunities, those who are in the rural areas, marginalized areas, cannot access those. You can find one person like Tegla and brother and sister or whatever, because we have a better education, maybe it's a CEO, secretary, everything down. The other person, they will stay there like that forever. They will not be able to educate their brothers. And that's why we see many friends, for example like her, that she's trying to open more eyes for other people so that they can reach places. But you now, you are the roots of Wanjiro. You are the roots of others. That you go to our marginalized brothers and sisters to try and educate. See that member of parliament, you know, let's talk. See that woman, let's talk. Please help our people so that we can grow together. All of you tomorrow to be a leader. I think this game will be in a different. We will have a different world, really. And we'll be visiting all of you, say, oh, she's a director somewhere. She's a principal somewhere. For you to be a principal somewhere, you'll be able to open your eyes and take those marginalized boys and girls to your school. And try also to talk to friends, to give scholarships. That's how this leadership, you women of today, you are good girls and you'll be leaders. And we live in a better place. Okay, if you don't get a job, because not all of us cannot get a job, but create something like what she did. You can create something that you will employ more. Creation alone will change our world. And try to respect your people. You remember when you know the other lady when she was giving a talk in Kapoor, but I was not happy because of the attitude that she was in the outside and she from Senegal. Say now, how are people in Africa? I don't care for them because they are not good people. But God has given you that opportunity to speak. And she became completely arrogant and was like close to cry. That's not to be example. See, no, I'm a CEO of the fashion something, you understand that today? I'm a CEO of this fashion and my company is growing. Now I don't want to bother with others. Are you giving a good example? And now he was speaking in front of 9 first ladies, 3 presidents of Africa. So you are like, all of us wanted to go under the table. Because now that woman was example, is like one of us. Now I'm talking on behalf of you. One of you to say bad things is like you are plucking. Yeah, you are just making the rest of you to be, to feel like going under this step because you are an example of that group, of this group. You understand what I'm telling you?
Yes.
So with those few remarks, my sister, I want to say school is going to open tomorrow. I wish you all the best. I want to see the good results, and I want to see some of you doing sports. And Wajiru will be telling me that so and so is doing very well in this in the academy or the sports. So come and visit. So some of us will be going down to Tana River to see what's happening with us.